Good morning. You're listening to FloorDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Haar. This morning, my guest is Chuck Bode, the co-owner of CB Floors and also the chairman of the board of Starnet. Chuck, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Kemp.
Well, that's good to hear. I say it's good to hear because there's a lot of folks in your sector, especially those that are focused in the corporate office sector, that are curious about what's going to happen next year. But let's get to that in just a minute. First, let's talk about Starnet. I know that you at one time had a meeting set up. You've had to cancel that this fall, but you've got a board meeting and then you've got a virtual shareholders meeting. I'd like to know also how's the health of the membership. Give us an update on Starnet.
So we did have the fall meeting that was originally scheduled for Louisville in early October, and I'm sure you know what's going on down there if you read the paper. Between that and COVID, we decided not to have that live meeting and instead have a virtual meeting, which is going to occur on October the 9th. The day before that, on the 8th, the board of directors will get together for a couple hours to discuss the state of the world. The other factor that went into the equation in canceling the meeting was a lot of our members are reluctant to get on an airplane. Obviously, it's been a bit discouraging this year that we haven't had any live meetings. The Starnet staff really works hard to stay in constant contact with our people and assist our membership and to attempt to be relevant through this black swan event, which we hope soon ends.
Let's mention the situation in Louisville. Is it not just the virus, but this Breonna Taylor situation has created a lot of rioting, and the property that you were planning to go to was vandalized, so it wouldn't end there for you.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Omni Hotel was vandalized during all the protests, and they're not really ready or weren't ready at the time to receive guests as a result of the protests that are ongoing in that city. We decided, along with COVID, to cancel the live meeting.
Well, I know the Starnet group, the core group, is like family. You guys talk all the time. Tell us what's going on. Tell us how the members are doing. I mean, because we hear the backlog is carrying a lot of members through, and it's the potential that business in 20 may not be badly affected versus 19.
The real irony of this pandemic is that many dealers are really having a terrific 2020.
Yeah.
And the reckoning from the pandemic is not going to be felt by the commercial flooring contractor until next year. And I really think at this point that the die is cast for 2021, and commercial finish trades always recover last in any recession cycle, and I think that's what's going on at the moment. So if you talk to most Starnet dealers like myself, they're having a great 2020,
yeah,
but a lot of concern about what's going to happen next year.
There's several things that we can look at that kind of give us that indicator. One of them is the Architectural Billing Index, which in April dropped way down. And is actually now, the last read was July, was at 40, where 50 means that it's healthy or anything over 50 is healthy. And that's a 9 to 12 month window on what's being designed. And there's almost a paralysis out there in the marketplace right now as far as what do we do as far as future projects, right?
Business people such as myself hate all this uncertainty.
Yeah.
Between the election that's ahead, the protests and turmoil that's ongoing in multiple cities, and the real uncertainty of where this virus is headed over the winter, I think there is an unease out there in the country that's paralyzing the way forward here. Now, speaking specifically to the design community, you know, many of those people are still not back in the office, and many of them are still not accepting visitors from the mill reps. So
yeah,
a lot of business trying to be transacted in new ways, but it can only impede business. It's not a good thing, and I think one indicator that needs to be looked at is a simple sample request. When you look at what's going on out there, it's very troubling.
So that's way down, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah. We took a read of the A&D community, and it's going to be in our next issue, which you'll see next week. We asked them what the fastest growing sectors were for them, and this was just, you know, a few weeks ago, so it's now post-COVID type of information. And it's acute care is number one, multifamily housing is number two, K through 12 is number three, tenant improvement is number four, and corporate's number five. And the ones that are just falling off the list are hospitality, senior living, public space, and retail. So that's a read from a few weeks ago.
It's interesting to see what's going on. Residential remodel and new home builder businesses are on fire at the moment.
Yeah.
But true commercial sales are under really severe pressure, I think, as the year winds down. Corporate space, for example, is under pressure as employers try to read the tea leaves on what exactly is going on here as far as office space needs and when people might get back to work. That's got some issues with it. And as far as healthcare, everybody thinks healthcare is going to be really ramping up at some point, but
yeah,
I think during the COVID era, a lot of these hospitals were strictly focused on treating the virus. Everything that they made money on, all their elective surgeries and things of that nature, were put to the side. So there's a lot of hospitals that are having financial trouble at the moment, and I'm sure that's going to result in a decrease in capital spending moving forward. As far as the educational side of our business, state budgets are in absolutely miserable shape. It's going to be interesting to see what happens with the federal government on their next stimulus package. But there's no way with the layoffs they're going to have that they're going to be spending a whole lot of money, in my mind, frivolously, on capital improvements in the next 12 to 18 months. I just don't see it happening. Mm-hmm.
So what advice do you have for the membership of StarNet? If I'm hearing you right, you're saying it's time to buckle down. It's going to be a rough ride for the next couple of years. So what are you guys as a collective group saying to each other?
Most commercial contractors are burning through their pre-pandemic backlog, and they're not really replacing it at the same rate with new sales.
Yeah.
As the backlogs wind down and the PPP money runs out, I think commercial flooring contractors and contractors in general are going to need to make some hard decisions about next year about right-sizing their cost structure moving forward. These events are occurring later than most people would think, because they would think they would occur during the actual height of the COVID infection, but actually the effect on our industry is coming much later than that. And it's going to happen in 2021. I really feel that that's the case.
And the federal government's tapped out. They're not going to be able to help you guys, are they?
I don't know what the federal government's going to do, because it's so much up in the air and who gets elected and things of that nature. They don't seem anxious to make a deal of any sort. I'm not sure how I feel about spending more money anyway, but it's more of uncertainty for people like myself, and that's really what we don't like. We don't know where the world is headed at the moment, so it causes a lot of consternation for most business people.
Well, you being somewhat of a conservative advisor and with a law degree and all the experience that you have, I think what you're telling us is that you're concerned, but it could go either way, right?
It could. I think for the next 18 to 24 months, it could be a tough ride for commercial flooring contractors. Now, if you're in a business that has more diversity and you have a retail business or you have a home builder business to go with your commercial work, you'd probably be in better shape. But if you're 100% strictly commercial, say with a focus on corporate office space, there's probably some concerns out there. Mm-hmm. We'll have to see how it plays out, but I'm not in a particularly great frame of mind about the state of the economy at the moment.
Okay, Chuck. Well, I appreciate you giving us this read. And you come from a base of business that's probably the biggest in the business, so it's good to hear what you're thinking. Again, by talking to Chuck Bode, the chairman of the board of StarNet and the co-owner of CB Floors. And you've been listening to Kempar and FloorDaily.net.